Discussion on aortic stenosis, TAVR versus surgical AVR. As with other cardiac conditions, ACC AHA guidelines divide aortic stenosis also into stages A to D. In stage A, there are conditions which can lead on to aortic stenosis like bicuspid aortic valve or aortic valve sclerosis. Stage B is that of progressive mild to moderate aortic stenosis with leaflet calcification, fibrosis, or commissural fusion. Stage C is asymptomatic severe aortic stenosis, which is subdivided into C1 without left ventricular systolic dysfunction and C2 with left ventricular systolic dysfunction with left ventricular ejection fraction less than 50%. Severe aortic stenosis has valve area less than or equal to 1 square centimeter, mean pressure gradient more than or equal to 40 millimeters of mercury, or aortic Vmax more than or equal to 4 meter per second. Very severe AS has aortic Vmax more than or equal to 5 meter per second, or mean pressure gradient more than or equal to 60 millimeters of mercury. Stage D, symptomatic severe aortic stenosis, is subdivided into D1, D2 and D3. D1 is the high gradient aortic stenosis with aortic Vmax more than or equal to 4 meter per second or mean pressure gradient more than or equal to 40 millimeters of mercury and aortic valve area less than or equal to 1 square centimeter. In D2, aortic valve area is less than or equal to 1 square centimeter with resting aortic Vmax less than 4 meter per second or mean pressure gradient less than 40 millimeters of mercury. But dobutamine stress echocardiography shows aortic valve area less than 1 square centimeter with Vmax more than or equal to 4 meter per second at any flow rate. LVEF is less than 50%. This is low flow, low gradient aortic stenosis. D3 is paradoxical low flow severe aortic stenosis with LVEF more than or equal to 50% and stroke volume index less than 35 ml per meter squared. Aortic valve area is less than or equal to 1 square centimeter with an aortic Vmax less than 4 meter per second or mean pressure gradient less than 40 millimeters of mercury as in stage D2. Aortic valve replacement, either surgical or percutaneous, is indicated in those with symptomatic high gradient severe aortic stenosis, D1. In asymptomatic patients, it is indicated if LVEF is less than 50%, C2. Those with stage C1, asymptomatic severe AS with normal LVEF, valve replacement is indicated along with other cardiac surgery if indicated. Aortic valve replacement is also recommended in symptomatic patients with low flow, low gradient severe AS with reduced LVEF, D2. In stage D3, symptomatic patients with low flow, low gradient severe AS with normal LVEF, aortic valve replacement is considered if aortic stenosis is the most likely cause of symptoms. All these are class 1 indications. In summary, class 1 indications are for stage C2 and D. C1 is considered along with other cardiac surgery. In addition, there are several class 2A and 2B indications as well. Basically, class 2A indications are in stage C1. A common denominator for these situations is a low surgical risk. In stage B, there is class 2B indication along with other cardiac surgery. While considering the choice between a bioprosthetic valve and a mechanical prosthesis, age below 50 years is the cutoff for preferring mechanical prosthesis and age above 65 years is the cutoff for bioprosthesis. 50 to 65 years is the gray zone. Bioprosthetic valves have a higher and earlier deterioration in younger age group. Those in whom long-term anticoagulation is not feasible, bioprosthesis is considered. Choice is based on a shared decision-making process in most situations. The choice between surgical aortic valve replacement and transcatheter aortic wall implantation is mainly for those in whom bioprosthetic valves are indicated. For those below the age of 65 years or a life expectancy more than 20 years, SAVR is preferred. In the 65 to 80 years age range, either SAVR or transfemoral TAVI can be considered after a shared decision-making process. TAVI will be recommended in those above 80 years and in younger patients with a life expectancy less than 10 years. In all these situations, there should be no contraindications for transfemoral TAVI as it is the recommended option. When vascular or valve anatomy is not suitable for TAVI, SAVR is considered. If the surgical risk is high or prohibitive, TAVI is considered if survival beyond 12 months with reasonable quality of life is expected. Discussion so far is based on ACC AHA guidelines 2020. ESC EACTS guidelines for management of valvular heart disease were published in 2017. The guideline mentions that data on TAVI are limited for patients below 75 years and for low surgical risk patients. Hence, SAVR was preferred in those patients. On this aspect, the more recent ACC-AHA guidelines incorporate more recent evidence. In ESC-EACTS guidelines, SAVR is preferred if STS Euro score 2 is less than 4% and TAVI if it is more than or equal to 4%. TAVI is preferred in those with severe comorbidity, previous cardiac surgery, frailty, and restricted mobility. SAVR is preferred if there is a suspicion of endocarditis.